Upuru, that is the name of my bow. She was once an enormous river purr. She called to me so strongly I could hardly hear anything else, even as a young girl.
I've never heard of that happening before.
Neither had my parents. I would wander from my tribe for days. Mother organized great search parties to drag me back home. I always snuck away soon after.
Where did you find Upuru?
I woke before dawn on the day I turned 15, the call pounding in my head. Upuru was there, waiting in the shadows outside my village. The beast I'd scoured the rainforest for just days earlier. The bitter irony.
Well, she's a nice bow.
That's a grave understatement.
Why'd I open my mouth?
Heya.
What's this? Pontita.
You don't have to say anything. The fact that you're here means something went wrong.
Seems more like everything's going wrong.
All right, that's enough. I know you're going through a lot. But stand up straight and get ready to face it.
What?
Are you going to mop while your family needs you? No! Now get in there and serve some customers!
So excited.
Mm.
Thanks.
How do you snap out of it, recruit? You're going to get out there and find
maybe,
and you're going to make that antidote.
Yeah,
and you're going to see your wife and kids and be a happy family again.
Yeah. What's this?
Is the coast clear? Lend me thine ears, fellow citizens, for I have a tale most magnanimous to tell.
Whoa, wait a minute. Who are you?
Well, mine good fellow, thine is a question fraught with existential intrigue. In the simplest of terms, I have the high honor to be Thane Paz the Brilliant, founder and illustrious leader of the Scowlheart Bandits.
You... you stole the hearts! Do you have any idea what you've done?
Hearts? From whence doth this accusation spring? To pronounce such a slight on our honor!
I don't have time for this. Where are they?
Oi, no one cuts off the Fang, does it? Now you'll have to answer to me. Ah, yes, the hearts. Safely in our keeping. Of that I doth assure thee. And you ain't gonna get your hands on them unless you go through me.
Fine, let's do this.
For centuries, this... oh, wouldst thou look at the time? We've scarcely 4 and 20 pence before the next match. In light of thine outburst, mine sumptuous soliloquy must wait. The tragedy. Thine theme ingredient this morrow is... mochi fruit.
Tree. Have you ever seen a cook make a meal without seasoning?
No, that sounds pretty gross.
You off your load. When your pie's thick with spices, it's all a mess, innit?
At least this'll be an easy match.
As the illustrious, willst be thine judge, and it wouldst be mine great pleasure to partake in a dish of fire. Let the majesty of mine judging commence! Marvelous! Is heavenly. And lo, with a single flex of his mighty cooking muscles, Thrash claims victory!
All right! All right, I won. I'd like my hearts now.
Not happening. Never trust a bandit, mister.
Wait! Now, my boy. 'Tis not polite to go against thine word. Verily, we shalt give you thine heart, but thou hast only earned one.
What happened to your word?
One for one, 'tis the code that governs all our wisdom. That is to say, one heart for one duel. I remain the man of mine word, but so too am I one of mine code.
You can't be serious. I need them all now.
Oh, wouldst thou look at the time? 'Tis mine fate to always be in a hurry. Come, Riv, we must take our leave before Kamen arrives.
They really were serious.